Well, good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
So, what a delightful day. Lovely weather. So far, so good. I spent yesterday and Friday putting new plants in pots outside the rectory, so it's a little garden out there. We'll see if they survive. Maybe. So, you can find a link to the bulletin on our Facebook page. And a reminder that in the weeks to come, we will start trying to transition over to YouTube Live for our Sunday morning worship. So that way people who aren't on Facebook can more easily find it and watch it and participate. And then we can take the feed from YouTube later when it's done and put it over on Facebook. So it'll be there, but the live portion will be on YouTube instead. So be aware for that in the next coming couple of weeks. We'll get to use our new camera for that. Once I have someone who can help run the videography, but it's fun. We'll get to show you all these exciting things. Now that I hope everybody is all synced up, has their bulletin ready, their coffee, everything prepared, let us worship. Let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in your sight, O Lord, my strength and my redeemer. Lord, open our lips,
and our mouths shall proclaim your praise.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, it is now, and will be forever. Amen. Hallelujah.
The earth is the Lord's, for he made it.
Oh, come, let us worship.
Come, let us sing to the Lord. Let us shout for joy to the rock of our salvation together.
Let us come before God's presence with thanksgiving and praise the Lord and shout with psalms. For you are a great God. You are great above all gods. In your hand are the caverns of the earth, and the heights of the hills are yours also. The sea is yours when you made it, and in your hands to hold the dry land. Come, let us bow down and bend the knee, and kneel before the Lord our Maker. For you are our God, and we are the people of your pasture, and the sheep of your hand. Oh, that today we would hearken to your voice.
The earth is the Lord's, for he made it.
The psalm appointed for today is Psalm 105. I recite this together by the half verse. Not together, responsibly by the half verse. Give thanks to the Lord and call upon his name.
Make known his deeds among the peoples.
Sing to him, sing praises to him.
And speak of all his marvelous works.
Glory in his holy name.
Let the hearts of those who seek the Lord rejoice.
Search for the Lord and his strength.
Continually seek his face.
Remember the marvels he has done.
His wonders and the judgments of his mouth.
O offspring of Abraham, his servant.
O children of Jacob, his chosen.
He is the Lord our God.
His judgments prevail in all the world.
He has always been mindful of his covenant.
The promise he made for thousands of generations.
The covenant he made with Abraham.
The covenant he made with Isaac.
Which he established as a statute for Jacob.
An everlasting covenant for Israel.
Saying, to you will I give the land of Canaan.
To be your rod and inheritance.
Hallelujah.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. The first reading is from the book of Genesis, chapter 29. Laban said to Jacob, "Because you are my kinsman, you should therefore serve me for nothing. Tell me, what shall your wages be?" Now Laban had two daughters. The name of the elder was Leah, and the name of the younger was Rachel. Leah's eyes were lovely, and Rachel was graceful and beautiful. Jacob loved Rachel, and so he said, "I will serve you for 7 years for your younger daughter, Rachel." Laban said, "It is better that I give her to you than I should give her to any other man. Stay with me." So Jacob served 7 years for Rachel, and they seemed to him but a few days because of the love he had for her. Then Jacob said to Laban, "Give me my wife that I may go into her, for my time is completed." So Laban gathered together all of the people of the place and made a feast. But in the evening he took his daughter Leah and brought her to Jacob, and he went into her. Laban gave his maid Zilpah to his daughter Leah to be her maid. When morning came, it was Leah, and Jacob said to Laban, what is it that you have done to me? Did I not serve you for Rachel? Why then did you deceive me? Laban said, "This is not done in our country, giving the younger before the firstborn. Complete the week of this one, and we will give you the other also in return for serving me for another 7 years." Jacob did so and completed her week. Then Laban gave him his daughter, Rachel, as a wife. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
We will recite responsibly by the whole verse, Canticle D, the Song of the Wilderness. Except by the whole verse. "The wilderness and the dry land shall be glad, the desert shall rejoice and blossom.
It shall blossom abundantly
and rejoice with joy and singing. They will see the glory of the Lord, the majesty of our God.
Strengthen the weary hands and aid firm and feeble knees.
Say to the anxious, 'Be strong, do not fear. Here is your God coming with judgment to save you.'
Then shall the eyes of the blind be opened, and the ears of the deaf be unstopped.
Then shall the lame leap like a deer, and the tongue of the speechless sing for joy.
For water shall break forth in the wilderness, and streams in the desert.
The burning sand shall become a pool, and the thirsty ground springs of water.
The ransom of God shall return to singing with everlasting joy.
Joy and gladness shall be theirs, and sorrow and sighing shall flee away.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen."
A reading from Paul's letter to the Romans, chapter 8. The Spirit helps us in our weakness, for we do not know how to pray as we ought, but that very Spirit intercedes with sighs too deep for words. And God, who searches the heart, knows what is the mind of the Spirit, because the Spirit intercedes for the saints according to the will of God. We know that all things work together for the good of those who love God, who are called according to His purpose. For those whom He foreknew, He also predestined to be conformed to the image of His Son, in order that He might be the firstborn within a large family. And those whom He predestined, He also called. And those whom He called, He also justified. And those whom He justified, He also glorified. What then are we to say about these things? If God is for us, who is against us? He who did not withhold His own Son, but gave Him up for all of us, Will he not with Him also give us everything else? Who will bring any charge against God's elect? It is God who justifies. Who is to condemn? It is Christ who died, yes, who was raised, who is at the right hand of God, who indeed intercedes for us. Who will separate us from the love of Christ? Will hardship, or distress, or persecution, or famine, or nakedness, or peril, or sword? As it is written, for your sake we are being killed all day long. We are counted as sheep to be slaughtered. No, in all these things, we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. For I am convinced that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor rulers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Next, we'll say Canticle 19, the Song of the Redeemed, recite together. O ruler of the universe, Lord of God, great deeds are they that you have done, surpassing human understanding. Your ways are ways of righteousness and truth, the King of all the ages. Who can fail to do you homage, Lord, and sing the praises of your name? For you alone are our holy God. All nations will draw near and fall down before you, because your just and holy works have been revealed. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever.
A reading from the Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus put before the crowds another parable. The kingdom of heaven is like a mustard seed that someone took and sowed in his field. It is the smallest of all the seeds, but when it has grown, it is the greatest of shrubs and becomes a tree, so that the birds of the air come and make nests in its branches. He told them another parable. The kingdom of heaven is like yeast that a woman took and mixed in with 3 measures of flour until all of it was leavened. The kingdom of heaven is like treasure hidden in a field, which someone found and hid. Then in his joy he goes and sells all that he has and buys that field. Again, the kingdom of heaven is like a merchant in search of fine pearls. On finding one pearl of great value, he went and sold all that he had and bought it. Again, the kingdom of heaven is like a net that was thrown into the sea and caught fish of every kind. When it was full, they drew it ashore, sat down, and put the good into baskets, but threw out the bad. So it will be at the end of the age. The angels will come out and separate the evil from the righteous and throw them into the furnace of fire, where there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. Have you understood all this? They answered, yes. And he said to them, therefore every scribe who has been trained for the kingdom of heaven is like the master of a household who brings out of his treasure what is new and what is old. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
And yet more parables today. I think this is last week. Pretty sure this is the last week of parables. I really do love parables, and I credit the New Testament scholar Amy Jo Levine for her teaching on this area. Parables are open-ended, so explore them. Get into the story, because that's how Jewish teachers of the time would have operated. And then later generations of Christian theologians would do the same. They would treat them as allegories, something that could be interpreted and reinterpreted over and over again, because the whole story and every little detail could have significance. The last few weeks we've had just one parable of the day to work with, and this week we have parable after parable, tossed one after another. With fewer details, sure, but they're not the same. They cannot be boiled down and reduced to one single idea. But before I interpret the parables with you, I I'm going to take a detour for some poetry. Stay with me. Listen carefully. Tell all the truth, but tell it slant. Success and circuit lies. Too bright for our infirm delight, the truth's superb surprise. As lightning to the children eased with explanation kind, the truth must dazzle gradually, or every man be blind. Some of you may recognize these lines of Emily Dickinson. I'll repeat the poem later, but savor it. Keep it in the back of your mind as we go. We have in the parables for today a couple of important images. The mustard seed, some yeast, a treasure buried in a field, a merchant seeking the finest of pearls, a net for fishing. The kingdom of heaven is like all of these. From the fabulous to the mundane, from the small seed to a big net, from a living thing like seed or yeast to inanimate objects, each thing is lifted up to tell us about the kingdom. But the correlation is not one-to-one. They are alike, and they are unlike. Hence the proliferation of parables. The kingdom of heaven is a small thing, but grows large, a mustard seed. The kingdom of heaven is a small thing, but changes whatever it touches, yeast in a huge batch of dough. The kingdom of heaven is a treasure hidden in a field. If you stumble upon it, you would do whatever it takes to have it. The kingdom of heaven is a merchant seeking a priceless pearl. If you truly desired it, you would sell all you have to make it part of your life. The kingdom of heaven is a fishing net tossed into the sea. It will grab you at the end of the age, and the angels will sort you. The kingdom of heaven is all these things and more. You can't be neutral. It will leaven you. It will grow. It will seize you and fascinate you and draw you into its world. Fight it, and you might find the angels tossing you. Pursue it, and you will have it, and it will have you, and you will be changed. Such is the kingdom of heaven. Jesus does not talk about it directly. How does one describe a vision of perfect beauty? How can we describe perfect justice and love? How would we open our ears and hearts and minds to perceive and understand the fullness of God? And so, Jesus talks in parables. He talks in circles and stories that you might ask questions, you might wonder, and desire and put your heart inside the kingdom. It is not a thing your brain can completely comprehend. It is not a thing you can seize by force. It is not a thing you can even get into with the best of intentions. Only pure desire for God can get you there. And if we speak honestly, then it is not even a thing. The kingdom of heaven is a divine reality, not just something beside others. We are to desire the kingdom. I say desire, not love, though they are the same. They should be. But love, we talk of love and make it soft and sweet. The way we talk, love squishes like a marshmallow, when it should be a marshmallow sizzling with flames, scorching and flaming and burning, yet not burning up. Love God, and I mean desire God. Love the kingdom and desire it. A flame that desires not to be put out, but a flame that desires to burn into an inferno. That is love. That is the kingdom. Not safe, not squishy, but a flame. Not directed, not dissected, but you can perceive it if you glance askance at the kingdom and let the corner of your eye see your beloved and let your heart skip a beat. The kingdom of heaven is to be desired with passionate love, and it will change you. Do you want to see the kingdom of heaven? Do you want to pursue it? Look to Jesus. Grab at his cloak, follow him, shout at him until you see his eyes, and then grow silent. No words, no parables, only desire. I cannot explain to you the kingdom of heaven. It is not a political program, anything like an earthly reign. It surpasses all understanding and fulfills all things. And it is the fullness of God that will fulfill all things. Our Lord used parables to whet our appetite, to spark our minds, to ignite our desire. Do we dare let the parables work their power on us? Do we dare to seek the kingdom? Dare to desire it, dare to let God show it to us in reality surpassing words? Do we dare to inhabit the kingdom where we are and let it grow? Tell all the truth, but tell it slant. Success in circuit lies. Too bright for our infirm delight, the truth's superb surprise. As lightning to the children eased with explanation kind, the truth must dazzle gradually, or every man be blind. The Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven. And is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Thank you.
Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Show us your mercy, O Lord,
and grant us your salvation.
Clothe your ministers with righteousness.
Let your people sing for joy.
Give peace, O Lord, in all the world.
For only in you can we live in safety.
Lord, keep this nation under your care.
And guide us in the way of justice and truth.
Let your way be known upon earth.
Your saving help among all nations.
Let not the needy, O Lord, be forgotten.
Nor the hope of the world be taken away.
Create in us clean hearts, O God.
And sustain us through your Holy Spirit.
O God, the protector of all who trust in you, without whom nothing is strong, nothing is holy. Increase and multiply upon us your mercy, that with you as our ruler and guide, we may so pass through things temporal that we lose not the things eternal. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Lord God, almighty and everlasting Father, you have brought us in safety to this new day. Preserve us with your mighty power, that we may not fall into sin nor be overcome by adversity. And in all we do, direct us to the fulfilling of your purpose. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Almighty and everlasting God, by whose Spirit the whole body of your faithful people is governed and sanctified, receive our supplications and prayers which we offer before you for all members of your holy church, that in their vocation and ministry they may truly and devoutly serve you, for our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And while we will not be singing in church, we will have hymn 530, Spread, O Spread That Mighty Word. So if you know the words, you may sing it at home. We will enjoy it without singing. Pray for the world for ourselves, pray for all of God's creation.
We pray for those in our parish. Michaela, Graham, Donna, Kylie, Ruth, Walter, Kathy, Nate, Amy, Denise, Andy, Catherine, the Parker family, Anita, Ethan, Alex, Lori, Cheryl, Aaron, Mitch, Bill, Michael, Joe, Maribeth, Bill and Barbara, Stuart, Stephanie, Adam, June, Anita, and the Turner family. We pray for Jeffrey Turner, who has entered his eternal rest. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Together, the general thanksgiving. Almighty God,
Father of all mercies,
we are worthy servants, give you humble thanks
for all your goodness and loving kindness
to us and to all whom you have made.
We bless you for our creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life, but above all for your immeasurable love and the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ, for the means of grace and for the hope of glory. And we pray, give us such an awareness of your mercies that with truly thankful hearts we may show forth your praise, not only with our lips, but in our lives, by giving up ourselves to your service and by walking before you in holiness and righteousness all our days. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit the honor and glory throughout all ages. Amen.
Almighty God, you have given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplication to you. And you have promised through your well-beloved Son that when two or three are gathered together in your name, you will be in the midst of them. Fulfill now, O Lord, our desires and petitions as may be best for us, granting us in this world knowledge of your truth, and in the age to come, life everlasting. Amen.
Let us bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all evermore.
Amen. Amen.